Hi everyone, I'm Stefano from SottoZen channel, and I recently uploaded this new VFX animation video where I have this badass alien tripod going around New York City and destroying everything they can. And in this tutorial I want to show you a little bit of the rigging process that's behind this project. And I will focus on the rig of the legs, because I think that an interesting solution here is a mixed rig. We have those mechanical parts that are simply bone parented to the armature, and then we have this part here that can more organically deform, and I will use some bendy bones for this. So we have a lot to talk about. Let's get started. So here we are inside Blender, and this is the tripod that I modeled and animated in my video. I want to quickly show you how my rig is working. I selected my entire armature, and pressing Ctrl and Tab I can enter into pose mode, and you can see here all the custom shape that I create and assign to each one of the controlling bones. For example, this arrow shaped one is controlling the pole target for this arm here. This big one at the base is moving all the character, and then I have this for the arms and this one for the entire body. In this different layer I put all the deformation bones, and I have two different kind of bone used in this rig here. Nothing complicated, but I want to show you how it works. So I have this simple IK chain for each one of the legs, and later I will show you how to set up this. Let me unhide both of the bone layers here. If I select this IK controller here, I can move the leg of my tripod using the IK features. But when I go down with my foot, you can see that I have this nice damping effect, and this is achieved using some bendy bones and some bone constraints that allow me to avoid this foot to go under the floor level. So in this video I will show you how to create and set up the rig for this kind of robotic leg. So here I have prepared this file with only all the elements of one tripod leg. You can see all the mechanical part. What I want to do to start is to create a new collection that we can call rig, and inside this collection with shift A we want to add a new armature single bone. So this is not intended to be a basic rigging tutorial, but let me remind some important aspect of armature inside Blender. When we select an armature, we have, you can see here, three different working way, and the first one is the object mode. And in object mode we can move, rotate or scale the entire hierarchy like any other 3D element in our scene. Pressing Tab we can enter the edit mode. You can see here the freeway, and now we are in edit mode. And in edit mode, once again like in all other 3D object, we can actually build up something. For example, I can extrude new bones of my chain, and then I can move around or rotate the elements in order to achieve the result that I am looking for. And in the last mode, the pose mode, you can also see that the selection color changes to better remind you where you currently are. We can actually see the behavior of the bone during the animation process, and we can set up some relationship between bones for example, using bone constraints. And most important, we can animate our rig, saving the keyframes. And if we go into edit mode, we can see that every bone is composed by three different elements. We have the tail, we have the bone body itself, and then we have the head down here. And let's go back into pose mode. When we are in pose mode, if I press R to rotate my bone, I can notice that a bone always rotates around its head. And this is important to remember when we are building our rig in order to know how to start and place in the right way our bones. So to start building our first chain, I want to move this bone somewhere up here. Let's frame this area. And in order to see my bone, even if it's between this mesh, I can go into the armature option and I can check this in front box here. When this is on, no matter how I orbit around, I can always see my bones through the mesh. And another thing that I love to do while I'm working with rig is going to object viewport display and switch from texture to wireframe to see even better what I'm doing. So when we are working with robotic or mechanical part, the placing of our bones is very important. We have to be very precise. In this case, our first bone will control all these elements here of this first section of our tripod leg. So because I hide away the body, we don't care too much now where the head of our bone is, but we have to be careful where to put the tail of our bone. And the right way to do this is to exit the edit mode and go here, select our mesh, enter edit mode, maybe switch to wireframe visualization, and then pressing Ctrl 1 with the circular selection tool, I can select these two elements, and in this way I know that the selection is now in the perfect center, and pressing Shift and S, I can move my cursor in this position. So now if I go back to object mode, I select my armature and then I enter pressing tab edit mode, I can select once again the tail, and with Shift S this time I will select selection to cursor, and now I am sure that my bone is perfectly aligned to the mesh. So now we want to continue with the second bone, and you see that I designed this mechanism to rotate around this sort of joint here. So what we can do is to go into object mode, select this mesh, enter edit mode, and selecting these two faces here, we can move our cursor in the perfect middle position. So now that we have our cursor in the right position, we can tab to enter edit mode, and pressing E, I extrude a new bone. And with the tail selected, I press Shift S and I select selection to cursor. And now we have the second bone perfectly aligned. The last bone that we need will only control this mechanical part here. It's not very important where it ends. We only want to extrude maybe along the Z axis, and we can put somewhere around here. So now let's rename all our bones, and the fastest way to do this is to select the bone, press F2, and then enter the name that we want. In this case, we can call this leg top, then F2 leg middle, and then this one F2 leg bottom. So now we want to move and control this chain using the inverse kinematic. Means that we will control these three bones using only one bone. And this is very handy in animation. It is the opposite of the forward kinematic, where you have to position bone by bone to reach the position that you want. So in order to have an inverse kinematic controller, let's extrude another bone from the last one, pressing E, and pressing the Y key, we can constrain the movement. We can align on the Y axis. And we want this to be aligned in this way, because this will be a controlling bone. And all our controller bones should be aligned in the same way of our world. You can see the X axis is oriented in the same way of the world X axis, the Z and the Y also. So now what we want is this bone to become the controller of this chain here. But the problem is that because we extrude this bone from the last one, this is still parented to this chain. If we go into the pose mode and we try to move this bone around, we cannot, we only can rotate it. And this is not good. So let's go back to edit mode and pressing Alt and P, we want to clear its parent. In this way, it will be no longer in relationship with this chain here. So now that we have our controller bone, we can also name this, pressing F2, maybe leg IKGTRL, IK controller. Now we are ready to set our first bone constraint. So we have to go back to pose mode. And because we want this bone to move this chain using inverse kinematic, we want this chain here, and in particular, we want this bone to have an inverse kinematic constraint assigned to it. And to do this, we have to first choose the controlling object and then shift select this bone. And then pressing Ctrl, Shift, and C, we go under this tracking section here, and we want to choose inverse kinematics. And now this bone has turned yellow, and means that a bone constraint has been attached to him. And if we go here under the bone constraint properties, we can see the constraint itself. So if we now select our IK controller bone and we try to move it around, we can see that we have our chain behaving like we was expecting. This is a inverse kinematic basic chain. So now before we continue, let me add another bone that we can put somewhere here. And this we pretend to be the controller of the tripod body, even if I delete all the other elements to focus on the leg. We need this bone in order to better see the behavior of this leg. And I show you what I mean right now. Normally, the leg chain is parented to the body. So let's do this. I select the top of my leg chain, and then I shift select this bone of that represent the body, and then Ctrl P. I want to make a parent relationship, choosing keep offset. So now if I go back in pose mode, I can move the body and the leg will react accordingly in the right way. But now we have a little issue. If I try to move my foot controller, my IK controller, you can see that also the body is moving. And this is because our IK constraint is propagating itself to infinity. Means because we parented this chain to these new bones, all the bones in the same hierarchy will inherit the IK properties. And this is not what we want. And to fix this, we have to go here under this chain length field, and we have to tell Blender how many bones we want to be influenced by the IK behavior. In this case, 1, 2, and 3. So let's go here, and instead of the default 0, that means infinite, essentially means all the bones that are available, they will be influenced. We want to put 3 in this case. And now if we try to move around once again our controller, you see that we restore the right behavior. The body bone stays still while our leg can move. So now I think it's time to start parenting some of this mechanical part to our bones. And because it's a simple process of bone parenting, we don't need to weight paint or have some kind of organic deformation. An easy way to do this is just to go into object mode, and then we can shift select all the part that we want to be controlled by, in this case the first bone, and then we shift select our armature. We can enter pose mode once again, and then we want to select the right bone, in this case this one, and then we press Ctrl MP and we set the parent down here to bone. We can try to move our body bone here, and you can see that the first part of our robotic leg is following nicely. So let's do the same for the second part. We can select this bone, exit the pose mode, and then shift select all the part that we want. I don't remember very well how many they are. Let's try this way. So I shift select once again my hierarchy here, my chain, and then Ctrl P, set parent to bone. And once again, we can test it, and you can see that I left behind some pieces. So I think we can use a little trick. We can move this somewhere here. Then we can go back to object mode. We can select the remaining pieces, and then we can go back here, pressing Alt G, we reset its position. And then I want to select the right bone, and then Ctrl P, select set parent to bone, and now I have all of them in the right relation. Lastly, we want this third bone here to control all these base mechanical parts. So once again, we want to select, maybe in the wireframe we can see better. So we have this part. Let's go back to solid view. Let's select this bone, and then Ctrl P once again, bone. So let's test to move our leg, and we can see that our leg is moving properly. We can now start building the second part of our rig, and this will behave a little bit differently because we want to have this kind of dumping effect. And we will use, to achieve this, some bendy bones. So let's Shift A and create a new bone. When you press Shift and A, you get a new bone direct positioned where your 3D cursor is. So in this case, in the center of my scene. So before we continue, I want to move this new bone in a new bone layer to keep things well organized. So I press M and I move and I select this second layer here. And now it disappeared because this second layer is not currently selected. So what I want to do, I click on this second just created layer and I can see my bone again. And in this way, I can focus only on this second part of the rig without having all these bones visible. So I want to grab this bone and I want to position it somewhere around here at the beginning of this tube, and then I select its tail and I want to bring it somewhere like in the center of this base here. So now I want to select this bone and right click to subdivide it into three different bones, and then I select this tail here and I want to align the first bone in the way that is aligned to the very first section of this tube here. And in the same way I select this tail and I want this to be aligned to the last section of this tube. Now, because we are going to use bendy bones, we have to change the display visualization of our armature from octahedral, that is the default way, to B-bone, that stands for bendy bones. So now with this visualization, we can actually see all the subdivision that we are going to add, going here under the bone property page in the bendy bones tab. We want to increase its subdivisions. We can use 16. If we go now in pause mode for only one moment, we can see that the behavior of this bendy bone are really peculiar and very powerful. They are used to animate tails or tentacles or something that needs to be very smoothly deformed. So in order to control this bendy bone change, I want to select this bone and then detach it from its hierarchy. So I press Alt, P and clear parent. And don't worry if it will snap into this orientation, it's only temporarily. So now if we go into pause mode and we try to move this object, we can move it freely. But what we need is this bendy bone to follow and stretch to the position of this control. And luckily we have a bone constraint that does exactly this job. So select the control object, shift select the bendy bone and then control shift C once again, and we want this time stretch 2. You see that our bones change color, and you can see that this stretch to constraint appear here in the bone constraints tab. So if we now try to move around our controller bone, we see that the bendy bones are following properly, but if we rotate, nothing happens. And we want to fix this, and to do this we have to select our bendy bone and go into its property page. Down here we have this start handle and end handle, and we want to change the end handle to tangent, and then we need to rename this bone to maybe GTR base and this one to GTR head, and let's rename also this one to bendy bone. We can now choose this GTR base, and you can see that this snaps back to the right orientation. And now if I select and rotate this bone, it follows perfectly. Alt R and Alt G to reset rotation and position for this bone. So now let's unhide both of our bone layers. Let's go back to edit mode where we can set up our parenting between our bones, and what we want to do is to select these two bones here from the bendy bones, the head and the base, and then shift select the IK controlling bone, and we want to parent them to this bone, keeping it offset. So now if we go back to pose mode and we move our IK controller, you can see that our base bendy bone is following. So what is missing now is the damping effect. We want somehow to avoid this bone to go under the floor level, and we can achieve this using another bone constraint. So select this, Ctrl Shift C, and we want to limit its location. So we select limit location, and in the constraint tab here we want to use the world space, and we know that is the Z axis that we want to constrain. So let's select minimum Z, and with the zero here, if we now try to go under this zero limit, you can see that we cannot. But to be precise, if you see, this constraint works from the head of this bone. So I want to rise up a little bit, and pressing shift I can do it precisely. So something like this is working fine. So now we have all our effect in place. Let's once again reset its position. So now let's continue assigning the remaining object to our armature. For example, we forgot this one, and we want this one to be controlled by this bone. So an easy and fast way to do this is to go here in the edit menu and uncheck these lock object modes in case you have turned it on. Let's uncheck it, and now I can select the other object while, for example, I am in pose mode in my armature. So I can select this object, shift select the bone that I want, and then Ctrl P, and once again in this case I want to set parent to bone. And if I move now, you can see that is following. And finally, now we want this tube mesh to be deformed by these bendy bones, but this time we cannot simply assign this object to the bone because we want it to be deformed nicely and in an organic way. So we can do this selecting our object, then shift selecting these three bones, and then Ctrl P, but this time we choose with automatic weights. And in this way, Blender will automatically and most of the time nicely assign all the vertex to the near and corresponding deforming bones, and you can see that it's working quite nice. The next step is to assign this free base object here to the last bone, Ctrl P, and this time bone, because these are rigid parts. And if we now give a quick test to our armature, we can see that it's working quite good. Well, I just realized that this video is probably longer than half an hour, so let me finish showing you the final result on my original scene here. We have the same kind of rig. Let's unhide the two bone layers, and if you see here, I only duplicated these bones two times in order to deform also the other tubes here. And now I can move using the inverse kinematic my leg, and I can compress and have this damping effect when my foot reach the ground. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. If so, please leave a like or a comment, or subscribe if you didn't do it yet. As always, I want to invite you to visit my main YouTube channel SottoZen, where you can find all my 3D animation and VFX video. And I thank you so much for watching this, and I really hope to see you soon again with another great video. Have a great day. Ciao.